In order to delegate authority with authority, you need to have people who know what to do with delegated authority. This Mary Phillips with 10 Minute Torah, day number 2, the Torah portion, Yitro. We're still in Exodus or Shemot chapter number 18. Today we begin reading with verse number 13, and it says, "And it came to be on the next day that Moshe set rightly to rule the people, and the people stood before Moshe from morning until evening." If we drop down to verse number 17, it says, "And the father-in-law of Moshe said to him, 'What you're doing is not good. Both you and these people with you shall certainly wear yourselves out, for the matter is too heavy for you. You're not able to do it by yourself.'" Cute thought there. It says in verse 21, "But you yourself seek out all from all the people, able men who fear Elohim, men of truth, hating unfair gain, and place these over them to be rulers of thousands, rulers of hundreds, rulers of fifties, and rulers of ten. They shall rightly rule the people at all times, and it shall be that they bring every great matter to you, but they themselves rightly rule every small matter. So make it lighter for yourself, for they shall bear with you." The delegation of authority, the delegation of responsibilities. In modern terms, a team will outperform an individual every time. And in almost every situation, unless you just have a terrible team, that's true. That's very true. A number of years ago, when it came to operation at House of David, I blew the shofar to open the service. I welcomed everyone. I led all of the worship music. I lit the menorah. I did all the praying. I did all of the teaching. And I did the benediction. Needless to say, by the time I got home, I was worn out. Y'all help me to understand that what I was doing, while well-intentioned and with the heart of leadership and urgency of wanting to see it done and done right, at least in my own estimation, I heard very clearly one day in prayer, "Son, it's time for you to push other people up. This is not about you. And you need to trust others with the opportunity to do what they can do, even if they do it wrong a few times. Teach them, equip them, train them, and then turn them loose and let them do it." And no, they're not going to do it exactly as you would. That's not the goal, and that's not the intention. The intention is that people need to step into roles of responsibility, and with that, they take on a sense of ownership. Then no one's going to try to root you out if you delegate authority to someone, at least not in a righteous community. The goal is to raise people up. Now, in the American leadership model, the idea is that if I have good people with me, in the American mind, they're underneath me and they push me up. And the servant leadership role and model, the idea is to take people in your hand and push them up higher than yourself. The goal is for one generation to promote the one coming behind them quickly on their heels and give them a foot up, a leg up, so that they go higher, go further, and do better than what the previous generation did. If we're always failing to get to where our forefathers got to, where those who walked before us got to, we're lagging behind. We're not making any headway. So it's not that we do not value those who go before us. We do. But the understanding is we build on the foundation that they have laid. We prove their credibility and their validity by building effectively on what they have established. Now consider the the Hebrew roots community. When Yitro walked into camp, people knew who he was. He was a well-known individual, it would seem. When he came on board and when he began to proclaim that Yod-Heh-Vav-Heh, Yahweh, is indeed the one true Elohim, as opposed to all the other supposed gods, it gave a sense of credibility. It gave a sense of validity to these people's walk. Not that Yah needed that, but the people were looking around. Is there anyone other than Moshe and Aaron that believes the way that they do? What if some celebrity, some well-known individual, were to begin to walk as we're seeking to walk? Someone out of Hollywood or politics or some music individual begins to record Hebraic worship. Would that give us the credibility that we think that we need? The reality is, that might be nice and people might get a little bit more of an attention as to who we are and what we're trying to do. But Yah's not relying on that. What he's relying on is everyday, normal individuals, just as we are, to step up to the plate and be willing to show compassion, to give mercy, to heal, to speak truth, to be light, to have his love upon our hearts and in our actions and deeds, to walk uprightly and righteously, to prefer someone else, to serve without fanfare. These are the models that Yeshua demonstrated for us, and that's exactly what Yah is looking for out of us, obedience and modeling the heart and character of Yeshua. So there are those that still struggle with denominational style leadership. And they feel, I was put upon, or I was deceived, or I was lied to, and the excuses go on and on about how it was that someone somewhere else did something to them or didn't do something for them, and it was offensive and seen as a violation of trust, and off we've gone. Leaving a particular environment over some issue of that nature and then coming to a new environment without resolving those issues, however, is very problematic. We may have changed locations. We may have changed styles, days of worship, mechanics. But if our heart hasn't changed and if our mind about leadership hasn't changed, then the changes that are really necessary haven't taken place yet. Yah is still in the business of raising up people to delegate his authority to, his power to, so that his kingdom can advance. Yeshua said so in the book of Matthew, chapter 16. He says in verse 18 and 19, and I say also to you that you are Kepha, and on this rock I shall build my assembly, and the gates of Sheol shall not overcome it. I'm building a successful assembly, he says. In verse 19, and I shall give you the keys of the reign of the heavens. Whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heavens, and whatever you loosen on earth shall be having been loosed in the heavens. I give you authority to make halakhic decisions. I give you authority to determine the right ways to walk in the Torah. I give these keys to you. I give you authority. Yah is still in the business of calling shepherds in the book of John, Yochanan, chapter number 10. He talks about himself saying that he is indeed the door to the sheep in verse 7. And that all who came before him were thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. And he said in verse 9, I am the door. Whoever enters through me shall be saved and shall go in and shall go out and find pasture. He teaches us here the model of a loving and caring shepherd. Yah is still raising up shepherds, pastors, people to lead, people to follow the model of Yeshua. So it's important for you and I to understand we don't need a celebrity. We need to be willing to be used. That's the key. And we'll see you again tomorrow. To this, shalom.